What is neuroimmunology? It's a study that the bidirectional influence or interaction between these two arguably most complex the physiological system in our body.
Tai Chi studies the connections and interactions between the brain and the immune system.
They both are based on a network of interaction of the cells, one case neuron, the other case is lymphocytes and many other immune cells. They both have memory. They both play a role in defense and in reaction to external stimuli, etc. And they cross regulate each other.
But could these interactions be harnessed for health benefits? Can we influence our own immune systems with our minds?
I was trained as a supposedly clinician back in the 90s, actually last century. But then I didn't go practice medicine, but went to graduate school in the United States. I became interested in T-cell biology. Then after graduate school, I went to National Institute of Health, where we study T-cell and the B-cell interaction for germinal center response. So I became even more interested in the intricacy of how T-cell regulate B-cell response.
And since setting up his own lab, Hai has continued to investigate how these two lymphocytes collaborate with each other and how these processes are regulated in the body. And this interest eventually led him to neuroimmunology, understanding how the brain influences the immune system.
I, as a child growing up, observed that many people claim their thinking exercise or qigong, that type of a practice, or bring out a health benefit. You know, in Chinese, there's a word we say, mian yi li. Loosely, it means, the your capability of sort of a general defense against a variety of potential pathogens or insults. So it has been claimed that the mental state would influence that ability. So making me wonder, what's the connection between our mental state and our with our sort of a physical health state.
So Hai and his colleagues looked to animal models, first attempting to identify and remove nerves that could be providing the link between brain and immune systems.
With the hypothesis that if we remove a nerve that potentially transmit neuronal signal into a lymphoid organ that can regulate the immune response, then we should see a difference in the immune response that the animal would generate. That's how we started. And then initially we indeed observed that by removing a splenic nerve in a mouse model, then following a model antigen immunization, the antibody response of the mouse was impaired.
The team found that the plasma cell response, the cells that produce antibodies in response to a vaccine, was influenced by activity in the spleen nerve. Removing the nerve reduced production of plasma cells following immunization.
Then we trace this neuronal signal carried by the spleen nerve upstream. Then we find that there are at least two important brain regions in the central nervous system that are important for this splenic nerve-dependent promotion of plasma cell formation. One is called amygdala, the other is paraventricular nucleus.
These regions can respond to certain behaviors or stimuli. For the mice in the experiment, this was mild stress. They were placed on a transparent platform too high for them to happily jump off of.
Under that mild stress, in these two regions, there are special subsets of neurons called a CRH neuron will be activated. And these neurons and their activation cause a signal in the splenic nerve that transmitted into the spleen. And that signal is presumably read by a special subset of the T cells. And that T cells will convert that nerve signal, then relay that signal to B cells, and that signal promote these B cells to become and expand as plasma cells.
they had found a route for a behavioural stimuli to modulate an immune response in the mice. And that opens the door to some fascinating possibilities if it can be replicated in humans. Hai thinks this link could offer a new target for drugs aimed at manipulating immune response, but this isn't the only outcome he's interested in.
One can start to imagine that at the conscious level, that we might have certain brain exercise that would influence the function of the limbic system, then subsequently influence how our immune system operate. It seems to become possible that one day we could design a thinking exercise that actually boosts your antibody response. Potentially you can have a central nervous system memory that can have an impact on a memory immune response. I find that's very intriguing and exciting.